All right, my name is Dave Ratt, and today I'm going to talk about crosstalk in shielded Cat5 cable, running analog down a data cable, and do some testing to determine whether or not in real world situations, crosstalk between the various twisted pairs is an issue that is audible or a concern for us. When running analog down a data cable, especially a Cat5e that has twisted pairs that are not individually shielded, and there's purely an overall shield protecting the pairs from the outside influences, one of the concerns is that these pairs, not being shielded from each other, if you were to run a very high level signal down one pair, would that bleed into the other pairs at a noticeable or audible level, which is obviously something we don't want to have happen to us in a live or studio environment where we can hear the sound of the wrong instrument coming down that channel. One may think, or it makes logical sense, that there should be. This is 100 meters long. I used an extra long cable to magnify any issues that may occur. And having them unshielded almost defies logic to think that there wouldn't be some sort of crosstalk issue. Conversely, the quality of the twisted pairs in a data cable, if those pairs are perfectly twisted, and if the balanced mic pre on the front end of the mixing board is good enough, then any signal that's influenced upon those twisted pairs should be canceled out by the balanced mic pre. Additionally, if the pairs are twisted well enough, they shouldn't radiate a lot of energy. They should radiate almost no energy. It should cancel it out before it even leaves the cable. So the design of the cable is such that it should have no crosstalk or very minimal crosstalk due to the quality of the pairs, as well as the balanced mic pre. On the other hand, not having the shielding is a definite concern. And the only real way to find that out is to do some testing. So this is what I've got. I've got a SoundTools 100 meter SuperCat cable. I've got a set of cattails with female XLRs that's plugged into a music source. And it'll get to a different song by the time I get there. That's going to a music source. And then the other three lines of the four channels are going to an Audix OM7, which is an extremely low-level dynamic mic, transformerless, that's 6 to 8 dB lower output than just about any other mic on the market, compared to a Beta 58 or SM58 or others. I've got another low-level dynamic mic, a Sennheiser 441. And for a condenser mic, I've got a Neumann U89 set into cardioid mode. Supercardioid mode, so that we've got kind of a various reference point of something that we might run into in the live environment. And having a line level cable, you can see that you may be able to see the music is clipping the channel. I'm going to turn that down a little bit. So I'm going to run the music about just into clip. We'll listen to that. And the gain differential on these mic pre's, I've got the Audix mic turned up almost all the way, so it's about plus 55 on the mic pre. I've got the music turned down almost all the way, so it's at almost minus 10. So we're about at least 60 dB differential in gain on the mixing console between the microphones and the music signals. And then what I'll do is we'll turn up each mic independently and we'll see if we hear any of the music. So first the music is, and now we will go to, let's start with the Audix. So I'm bringing this up. The speaker is very close. It's right here behind me. And we can see that I'm far away and we're just on the verge of feedback. And the music is completely inaudible. Now we'll go on to Sennheiser. Mm-hmm.
Hey.
And again, no audible music, and just to show the music's still there. And the music is clipping pretty hard on the console now. And finally, the Neumann. Try not to give you any feedback here that's too painful. And again, not even the slightest hint of music is bleeding through. Now I'll try all three at the same time. And even though we're running 100 meters of twisted pairs that are not individually shielded from each other, and we're running a very high level line level signal down one of the channels, the other three channels with mic level inputs and at very high gain show absolutely no sign of the music in the form of crosstalk. So I would say that based on this, I'm pretty comfortable that crosstalk, even in a non-individually shielded data cable, is not an issue. Cool. Ha ha ha!